Do you think the Jets are going to regret this deal, playing him this kind of money?
No, the Jets won't. He might regret it. He might regret taking the Jets money because there was probably comparable money out there somewhere else, and the Jets aren't ready. Le'Veon Bell is such a high IQ player. You know, I've seen more. There are many more explosive running backs than him in the league, but his craft is peerless. Think about the patience with which he runs. Forget about the explosion through the hole or whatever, because there are guys who are more explosive. Think about the patience with which he runs, waits for holes to open up, the anticipation. Think about his ability to catch the ball. All the things that Le'Veon Bell does exceptionally well are things you have to work your craft. It's not just like natural athletic ability. So he's a very high IQ player, and that will enable him to be excellent, I believe, especially coming a year off, saving his body for at least another year or two, like on an elite level. No one who gives Le'Veon Bell money is going to regret it, because when he's on the field, if he's not the best, he's among the best, because there's some new guys coming up, obviously. But he might regret it. He might regret going to a franchise that has never shown the ability to really get it done. He might regret it.
I agree with you. He might regret it. But that's not where my focus lies. I was going to touch on something else because I heard about what he said, but I hadn't seen it until just now. I like Le'Veon Bell. I've communicated with him on a couple of occasions in the past. I'm pretty ticked off at what I just saw. So let me get this straight, because you're listening to the Steelers fan now. So you decide not to show up and play for a franchise with Big Ben Roethlisberger as your quarterback, Antonio Brown and Juju Smith-Schuster as your wideouts, Vance McDonald and Jesse James at the time as your tight ends, I wouldn't call them elite, but a damn good offensive line, and clearly in line to Super Bowl contend. You don't show up to play for that team, albeit for the contract. I get that. But then you sign with the Jets and talk about Super Bowl? Sam Darnold, no number one receiver. Robbie Anderson is your number one receiver, basically. Not saying he can't play. He's not a scrub. He can play. But what I'm saying to you is this. What the hell are you talking about? What are you talking about? You were talking about a Super Bowl, and you went from the Steelers to the Jets. The reason why Joe Namath, Broadway Joe, is still relevant is because that's the last time the Jets have been to the Super Bowl. Ladies and gentlemen, I am 51 years old. Joe Namath won a Super Bowl for the Jets when I was 2. And that is the last time the Jets have talked about a Super Bowl. And you're talking about a Super Bowl? Come on now. And then not only that, remember, he was a hybrid guy, a guy that had 406 touches, 321 carries, 81 receptions. Last time we saw him in a Pittsburgh Steelers uniform. Wanted his money. What did he say? I'm not just a running back. I'm the number 2 receiver on the team. I should be paid accordingly. I'm a hybrid. So he was looking for 17 to 18 per. With the Jets, you got 13. 13, which is something you could have got from the Steelers. So I don't want to hear this stuff about Super Bowl, and then you go to the Jets, and you went to the Jets for the money that you went to the Jets for. I'm not saying that it's not justified, because I understand why he waited and held out, because he got the $52 million more of a guaranteed dollar than $25 million. I'm just saying, don't talk to me about Super Bowl when you went from the Steelers to the Jets.
I'll tell you why that's okay. I tell you why you're wrong about that. If everything's equal, sure, you'd be right. But when you really look at what the Steelers were offering him, it was $10 million guaranteed dollars. And he's sitting there going, you have got to be kidding me. They made him a low-ball offer. I understand why. Running backs, you don't want to pay him once they get to be his age. You already got production out of him. But he's missed time, so he's thinking, every play could be my last play. I want that guaranteed money. And then he gets $15 to $20 million extra guaranteed. Stephen A., this is a better place to work than anywhere else, right? But I'm quite sure if someone else offered you $20 million more extra guaranteed dollars, you'd be like, I was winning Super Bowls over there, but I tell you what, I can mess with you fellas for a while.
But here's what you're missing. I wouldn't depart from here to go to someplace else paying me $20 million and talk about Super Bowls. I talk about the money.
No, that's not true.
I'd say you paid me.
No, you know why that's not true?
So I'm here to do it.
You know why that's not true?
Do what I do.
Because once you get to the new place, whatever the reality of the perception or the perception was before you got there, when you get there, what are you going to be like? I don't want to rate?
Yeah,
you're going to want to rate wherever you go.
Yeah, but what I'm trying to say is that That's comparing apples and oranges. I believe I have the clout and the power to make that kind of difference.
So
a running back, you don't.
But he's not just a running back. He's a receiver, too.
But you got a second-year quarterback throwing it to you without a number one receiver to speak of. And I'm saying those circumstances. Listen, on a show like this, it's a two-man, three-man, women wrecking crew. You understand? This is what we do. I'm sorry, but you got 11 dudes on the field with you, 10 other dudes on the field.
That's
only on one side of the ball. The other side of the ball got a different 11. Special teams got a different look. I got to depend on 32 other people.
That's why he's going to regret.
I ain't talking about no damn Super Bowl.
That's why he's going to regret the Jets instead of maybe.
But that's what I just said.
Wait, instead of maybe another franchise.
But that's what I said.
That would have paid him nearly the same. But Steelers were not one of those franchises.
But I'm not knocking him for holding out on the Steelers. I'm saying
or leaving
go,
the
I'm
Steelers.
Saying don't go to. I'm saying don't go to the Jets.
But we're not arguing
and talk about
that.
Super Bowl. Go talk about the money. Don't give me no junk about the Super Bowl. You can't even beat the Patriots because you get out of the AFC East first.
He's bringing the right attitude to the Jets. The problem is it's not going to go anywhere because the Jets are a terrible franchise.
The right attitude.
Bringing the right attitude.
2 weeks ago, we were just lamenting the fact that he didn't show up to OTAs.
Well, not me. Not me. He's a veteran. He shouldn't be wasting his body in practice.
Yeah,
he knows what he has to do to get ready.
But we also talked about the fact that you're a veteran going to a new team. You're held out for a year. And we ain't talking about him practicing on football field. We talked about him showing his face to show that you're a part of this organization. We did say that.
Whatever Le'Veon Bell's been doing in his career so far, keep doing it. It got him this far.
Got it.